Hello and welcome to another one of my videos. In this one we're going to be making a tool, one that I've been meaning to make for quite a while now. It's a golden rule divider here so that I can measure proportions. For example, my head and eyes are the right proportion, my mouth's in the right place and stuff, but I want to make this tool for a little job I have on a ukulele. So I have been making this ukulele here, and the form or the shape of it is my own design. I didn't take it off a plan or anything, so I just want to check my proportions here with these calipers. If I measure the width of the fat part of the body, my top there is more or less right, and if I measure the length of the body, the skinny bit is also right. If I go from my bridge to the top of the neck, but round the other way, the neck is longer than the body part, so stretch that out and I find that yes, my body is roughly in the right place for the proportions, looking nice. Now I want to know where to put my hole, since it's there. If I was to take the proportions of the body as my base, then I would have it down quite low if I didn't have the bridge, and it would look okay. But since I'm putting a bridge and that's related to the neck, I can take the proportions from the body to the top, the bridge to the top of the body, and that will give me a position of about there. So that is going to be a much better looking and balanced proportions. So I'm going to take a couple of sticks of roughly the same dimensions, sort of the size and length of the dividers that you want to make, and at one end put a couple holes so that I can either use a nail, some wire, a peg, or in this case a little bolt with its nut to give us then the basis of your dividers. Then with a bit of paper, in this case newspaper, I hope we can see the lines here of what I'm going to be doing. Now I'm going to place my dividers on there, opened up, so that if I was to put some extra sticks there, it would make a five-pointed star like that. So that from here, I can now try and find the center of that, those points roughly, so that I can then draw a circle that is going to sit on. Then with some dividers, I'm going to, by trial and error, more or less mark out, divide that circle, that circumference, into five points. There we are. And now we can connect those to make our star. And there is nothing occult about this, it's just geometry, okay? It's not a satanic star or anything like that. It's just geometry. Now we need that star shape to get our proportions. In the point of the star, we're going to make the holes right on the intersection here and here. And two sticks are going to go pivoting from those two points there. The fourth pivot point we have, we get by anchoring that one there and then swinging it up to the opposite star point here and putting a hole. Similarly, the other one, swinging it up to the opposite of star, putting a hole, so that when you put it there, it's going to be your point. Cut one off and have one shooting straight through. Or another way to look at it is the intersection of the star bars. Here, this intersection, and then the bottom intersection here of the star. So now you're going to close that, trim them off, and then find the points and it's going to be a proportion of 1 to 1.685. So if this is 10 centimeters, it's going to be a 26.5 centimeters. Mine's slightly up, but it's close enough for me for what I want to use it for. So there's your golden ratio.